Welcome to Theological Grazing. This is an addendum to the hermeneutical principles that I talked about the other day. I talked about the principle of actually living the text, because we're not in a situation where the text of God's word is this hyper-rational thing. And I don't want that to be confusing. That doesn't mean that it's not rational at all. It doesn't mean you get to just like make up something about scripture. It doesn't mean that just because you feel good about something or you feel like the Holy Spirit is telling you something from the word that in fact is true. It still has to align with what it actually says, right? God gave us an actual word with actual language, and you do have to apply the typical means of understanding that. But it's not hyper-rational, meaning it's like that's not the only thing. That's not the only piece of this puzzle. So I want to add to that that, you know, not only do you have to live the text, but then also for deep understanding, I think you have to meditate upon the text. And this is something that every Christian, you know, even if you aren't good at like, you know, I'm going to sit and meditate for a long time about this certain scripture. That's not, you know, something that a lot of people do probably. And it's maybe not even something that a lot of people have time to do in today's world. I'm sure we could make time. But I don't necessarily mean, hey, you need to lock yourself in a room for an hour every week just to think about one particular scripture. That might be an okay practice for you, depending on your situation. But even just having certain passages of the Bible that you're constantly going back to, constantly thinking about, trying to work out all the more, thinking more in terms of the practical end of the text, right? What does this mean? Where does this, you know, where does this put me? What would this have me do? And how would this have me live different? Any of these things, like just thinking through it more deeply. What does this tell me about God and his world and how to live in the church? And every believer that I know who is older, right, who is in the kind of later stages of their life, will always say things like, I've been reading my Bible forever, right? I've read Paul in Romans or wherever it is that they're reading all the time, right? I mean, I've been reading it for decades and decades, and it just struck me today that, fill in the blank, right? That people come to these new insights over time. And of course, we should expect that because this is God's word. The infinite God has communicated to us in a way we can understand, but it's also not something that was given so that you should just be able to just right away, you just got it. You've figured it out. It's over. It's not like that. There are things you can know very quickly and right away from the scripture. There are things that the scripture is completely clear about for anybody that has the bare essentials of just understanding and reading comprehension. But because it's God's word, because of who God is, it's the kind of thing that will just keep giving too. It will just keep growing. It will your understanding will continue to grow as you meditate on any passage of scripture. So you need to be able to meditate on scripture. Now, what I don't want when we think about meditation is to think about it in terms of you know, for instance, as a hermeneutical principle, like we all of a sudden are in a place where we say, well, we can't say what a text means for a long, long time, right? I'm not allowed to say what it means until I spend however many hours meditating on it first, or I feel that, you know, I've really come to, you know, a deep place of understanding. I don't know that we need to do that. I don't want you to feel like when I come to the text of Scripture, it is something that I barely can understand, or it takes me forever to understand. I think that God provides us insight. This is why it's so important to always be reading and studying the Word of God. But what I want for us is that we be open to, as we grow in understanding, to come to a greater understanding of a text. And it's not to say that the first understanding that you have of a text isn't right. It can be. But as is often the case, it could be so much more, right? I talked about the principle that I use in thinking about it, like when you look up out at the sky, out into the stars, you know, it looks like, you know, there's a lot of stars, number one, unless you're living in a city. But like, it's, you know, it's incredible. But also, if you just keep looking deeper and deeper and deeper in any direction with a telescope, you see that there's actually more than you could even see. And then there's more beyond that. And then there's more beyond that. As well as when you use a microscope and you look down, and we started to be able to see things that were microscopic. And then we began to see things that were, you know, on the cellular level, and begin to see things. And we just kept going down and down and down. And it just keeps going, right? The world that God has made, it just, like, there's just more and more and more and more detail that can be found. And I think the Word of God is like that. And because of that, it takes great meditation, right? And I want us to be meditating upon God's Word, because that is how we will come to deeper insight. Not simply by just, you know, applying some kind of, you know, rigorous set of tools, right? We are, in a sense, excavating the text at times, but that's not all we're doing. We are determining context, but that's not all we're doing. We are trying to figure out via the grammatical historical method, you know, what exactly this word means, but that's not all we're doing. Right, because of the nature of language, and especially because of the nature of the Word of God, that it is God's living and active Word, we should expect that we will have to meditate on it. And we should delight in that. Right? That is a joy, actually, to come to newer and greater insight about God's Word over time. Well, that's all, folks. If you could help me out, rate and review this podcast, share it with a friend, go ahead and email me if you have any questions. We're out.